Okay, so I've been working on taking the roof off the donor truck, and you can see I've sawed it here. I took it loose. Well, now I don't know why I did that. Oh yeah, I guess I did. So I can trim it, and this will stay long. I'm gonna leave this long. I could have done that after, I guess. But it's ready to come off. I think it's too heavy. I might wait and get some help. Okay, there it is. So this is the donor roof, and it has a little bit of rust in it, not too bad. So I'm gonna take some time and fix that before I put it on the truck. So I'm gonna take and cut that out and get it ready for a patch. Well, I'm letting that seam sealer dry, or the rust prohibitive. I'm going to try to take the windshield and the rear window out. Okay, I'm going to cut the rubber on the inside, see if I can push this windshield out. Okay, so I got my bottle filled, and now I'm putting this piece in. I've already kind of started tacking it. So here we go. Okay, so there it is. The patch is welded in. And somebody asked, I had a question about seam sealer and what you could do to prevent the rust from coming back under the seam sealer, I think is what they were asking me. So what I'm doing is I've got it all welded in, and then this is a coat of rust treatment that I'm using, and I brush that on, and I'm going to let that sit, get down in there good, and then I'll do the body work and do the seam sealer last. And here's a little trick I learned. If you take the air when that stuff is still wet, you can force it into the little holes and divots and stuff. So after I put that on there, you saw me, I blew it with air. Now I'll just let it sit. I might put a little bit more on in the drip edge. And I treated the back side of the patch. So I think we're good. But there it is, that side's fixed. Next time I'll be hopefully putting it on the truck.